Hey, what's up, everybody? My name is Trophynut, and welcome back to Bioshock in our Let's Replay series, where we're still in Fort Frolic, in the Poseidon Plaza, which is now haunted by plastered spider splicers, which can randomly appear behind you. And I don't like that. So we can hear another spider splicer, but she seems to be a normal one. Oh, what the fuck was that? Kind of forgot about that one as well. So let's just take telekinesis, take the first aid kit, turn around, nothing's happening. So this is the place of jump scares, as you might already guess. And there goes the next spotlight. So we saw a spider splicer go into Robertson's tobaccoria. Okay, there we go. And the obvious choice is to go in after her. And there's nothing here. Oh, it was a Tuggish Pasha. I don't think I have... Yeah, okay, never mind. I have researched them thoroughly. So now we are at the tobacco store, which is actually locked off a bit, as you can see, because there's a keypad here. But I think this is where we can enter the 7774 code that we found in the other tobacco and alcohol store. There we go. So not really indicated that it's this one, but it's... closely linked enough that you would guess that. So another Eve hypo, we could use that. So let's enter in here. And there is, of course, a camera, which I'm gonna hack and buy out again. Because I'm... Well, I was going to say I'm a cheapskate, but I'm not really a cheapskate in this scenario, am I? Two anti-personnel rounds and $9. Let's search again, nothing. So let's pick up all the dollars. And what else is there to find in here? Because I thought there was a bit more than that. Never mind, I thought there was more. Apparently there isn't. So let's take the electric bucks and leave the tobacco stores. So that's another store done. There is an audio diary here. Guns blazing.
The good people of Ratchet didn't sign up to see us government type shutting down shops, killing their owners. Even with a ponce like Fontaine. But he brung it upon himself. Instead of copping it on the chin, bugger gets it into his head that he's gonna go down guns blazing. Who does he think he is? John Bloody Wayne?
We can get on top of this. We can. Here's what we do. We find Fontaine's will and make what was his go to where it was intended. And not into the pockets of us that put him into the ground.
So McDonough is an honorable man that tried to get everything that Fontaine owned into the, where it would belong, instead of into Andrew Ryan's pocket, which would be a bit bad. But, that's also another indication of how Fontaine actually died when he had to put up a last stand. He went down guns blazing, apparently. And now for something equally interesting. Eve's Garden, we've seen a lot of posters about Eve's Garden before. It's actually a strip club. So, Jasmine Jolene is the leading lady here. Andrew Ryan's favorite gal. So, hello, Big Daddy. Stop doing that. And now we can go in here. We get another plasmid memory.
Well, if it isn't the long lost Andrew Ryan. Come here, tiger.
So, this is an interesting one. As I said before, we get these memories because of... the fact that it's in the genes of the people we killed, the genes of the people that we got the Adam from, mainly. And of course, our own genes. And apparently this is a memory of Andrew Ryan, or at least that Jasmine Jolene chick that just went behind stage. So she greeted Andrew Ryan with a bit of enthusiasm, if I might add. And she went into the back, which we're gonna go to in a minute. Because this is a really, really interesting room for the rest of the story. So let's take a look around. So there's, of course, a bar, as there should be in each strip club. Not that I know, because I haven't been to a strip club myself yet. So sorry. Sorry on that account. Let's take a look around here. There's not much here. I mean, there's another one of those fancy fortune tellers. That's about it. And shotgun bullets. We don't really need that. Which is also really funny that there's shotgun bullets underneath the counter. And here is actually nothing at all. We don't need to hack that. I mean, we have enough stuff as it is. So let's head through this door. We can head upstairs, which actually leads somewhere else. I think it's one of the back rooms that we can access through the stairs, if I'm not mistaken. So let's whack that thing. Nothing in the ashtray. Sorry, didn't mean to hit it there. I wanted to search again. So now we're upstairs, which, well, provided the patrons of this lovely establishment with a nicer view of some balconies, I suppose. So let's take the telekinesis and another first aid kit, which we can't use because we're filled up. And I think, so now we're at the upper level of Poseidon's Plaza, we can go out here as well. And now we can actually hack these things from behind, so we don't need to do that later on. Yes, I can hear the spider spices, I know. Is he gonna go? No, okay, never mind. We have two turrets that can protect us. So there's nothing in here. So I was mistaken again. Okay, that was not... So now we can go further.
I thought you had forgotten about poor Jasmine, but I am so glad you didn't.
I'm sorry, Mr. Ryan. I didn't know. I didn't know Fontaine had something to do with it. What are you doing? No! No, don't, please! I loved you, dude! Don't, please! No! No!
So now we heard the untimely demise of Jasmine Jolene, who was, to put it lightly, a prostitute. So we know Andrew Ryan had a girlfriend, namely Diane McClintock, and she, well, since she got injured, Andrew Ryan took her to the, well, the Eve's Garden over here, and went to visit Jasmine Jolene on a regular basis. And something else happened here, so now we can see there's a corpse on the bed here. So, we can assume that they had sex, of course. And this is really fitting. We get another flashback right here. I'm not going to tell you yet what the reason is. But, well, let's check out her corpse now, shall we? So, hello, Miss Jolene. So, this is actually Jasmine Jolene's her corpse. So, we can search it. We can find fine gin, which we're not going to take. There's something a bit more interesting closer here. I don't know if it's under the bed. Yeah, it's under the bed. There we go. Pregnancy. Which might indicate what went wrong here.
That creepy Dr. Tenenbaum promised me it wasn't going to be a real pregnancy. They just take the egg out once Mr. Ryan and I had... Oh, I needed the money so bad. But I know Mr. Ryan's going to suss it out. Going to know I wasn't being careful. Going to know I sold the... Mr. Ryan's going to be so...
So now the audio went again for a little while. But this is a really, really important audio diary. So Jasmine Jolene was pregnant from Andrew Ryan. And Dr. Tenenbaum, who was at the time working together with Fontaine, took the egg, the fertilized egg, from her body. And, well, she sold it to them, to Tenenbaum and Fontaine. And Andrew Ryan was clearly not pleased by that when he found out that she was pregnant at a given moment, and he killed her for it. So what Fontaine did with that embryo, we might find out sooner rather than later. But there's another safe here, so let's hack this thing open. I think I'm gonna auto-hack. Yeah, there we go. And this is a tiny safe, but $23, another first aid kit, and more anti-personnel rounds, which we're full of actually at the moment, so why not actually equip that? Not that I use the pistol much. So now we have a splicer with a name again. Rodriguez, which we might assume is one of those splicers we need to kill. So he's actually at the bar. Okay. Okay, where are you going? Okay, where's he going?
He was
there we go.
But he was vigorous.
Get the photo before it completely dries up.
There we go. Hector Rodriguez, another nice picture.
All around the fort, taking life as you go. You're not. You're an angel. I've never painted an angel. Maybe I should. Lily Poppy.
So, you can already feel what's happening here. Sander Cohen is starting to think that I'm a very interesting subject for a painting. And apparently he likes his subjects dead most of the time, so... Let's go towards the artwork again and pop in our next picture. There we go. So we might have another a few other splices that just spawned. Not that I see any. Oh, up there. So let's hit that thing in the face. There we go. With a wrench jockey too, we can just whack most of them straight in the face. So let's add another picture. Use.
What's that look? You don't like it, do you? I don't need to be judged by you, by anyone. Screw you! Screw all you fucking doubters! Here's what I say to all of you!
And Sander Cohen loses his mind for a moment, and that's always bad for us. So now we have a little piece of music. You might know this piece of music as the Nutcracker. So let's whack these guys in the face. Equip telekinesis, and I'm gonna just walk around with a corpse. Oh, hi. We have a nice bit of music. I don't know if this is copyrighted, by the way, so might as well take it easy and talk over it a bit. There we go. So let's just take it easy, because we're going to have a lot of splices around here.
I'm going to...
So there's one splicer after the other, so I'm going to have to be really careful. Telekinesis is perfect for this. That was not really... the idea. Wrench jockey is amazing for this as well, because we need to be fast. Reloading would be bad. And they kind of get weird if you back battle. I think we did most of them. So that was about 15 splices, I think.
You'll have to forgive an old fool his artistic temperament. The birth is so close now. The labor pains can bloom the judgment and drive the passions of even the finest spirits.
So he actually apologizes for that, which is funny to say the least. I think we had... Didn't we have... Yeah, first aid kits, there we go. And we get another present. Look at that, a tiny present this time, because... I don't know, it should be a bigger present since we got just ambushed by 15 splices at once. But 5 electric bucks, $21, and 20 electric gels. So thank you, Andrew Ryan. Sander Cohen, Jesus Christ, why am I mistaking those two? So let's buy a few things. I thought I hacked this one. Let's auto hack it. Probably hacked the other one at the entrance. Let's buy proximity mines, because I'm going to take out... Oh, auto hack tools. That's actually really nice. I'm going to take out... Wait, I needed Eve Hypos as well. Well, there aren't any Eve Hypos. I'm going to take out another one of the big daddies in a minute. I can actually go back to the metro, so I hacked that one for nothing. So let's go back to Poseidon Plaza and try to find our last subject, which should be Kolb, the one that antagonized us to go to the record store, which we still haven't met yet. Okay, so there's another big daddy. I don't think there are any explosives around here again, which is sad. There are spider splices though, which is sad. Maybe hack this one. Do I need to take pictures of you? I'm gonna take pictures of you. There we go. Is there a little sister? There is a little sister. Yeah, I know. So there's another one of those. Yeah, keep making circles. I'm gonna kill you nonetheless. Why are you so mad? I'm gonna try and take him out. Let's take the electric gel. And I'm gonna start off with a frag grenade to the face. Swap back to electro bolt in here. Maybe even insect swarm. I think he doesn't like insect swarm as well. So that's... Alms away. Let's check the... Yeah, okay, so I have electric buck equipped. So that's the most important one. So let's... So let's unleash the bees. And then let's take the electric buck. Oh shit, I think the bees weren't that good of an idea. Because I'm gonna have a lot of trouble here. Oh, that's not what I wanted to take. That was what I wanted to take. So die. Die, please die. I think I got him. Yeah, there we go. Okay. So, where's the little sister? Did she... Where the fuck? Where the fuck did she go? She's gone. Seriously? I spend all those resources on just a big daddy? God damn it. I'm gonna hack this thing in the meantime. So let's buy that out simply. And let's invent a few things. So now... Oh, I completely forgot that. So there's a few interesting things we can also make with a U-invent. And I completely forgot about the tonic we can make here. Bloodlust. I want to make that because this thing is amazing. So bloodlust heals your body and your mind as you swing. Be red in tooth and claw with bloodlust. You gain small amounts of health and eve when inflicting damage with the wrench. So I'm going to switch that out for Scrounger. Because that's really interesting. So with the distilled water, we can make electric gel. So we're going to do that a few times. Because that's going to come in handy. I think I want a few more exploding bucks as well. And trap bolts, which are also really good in dispatching big daddies. So there we go. More of those. Maybe a few. Yeah, we can make heat-seeking rockets as well. Ammo inventor. There we go. We got another one. And then we have also booze hound, but I'm not gonna take that just yet. There we go. I don't think nothing drops out. We could use everything there is in this thing. So there we go. A full ammo pack of electric gel. Where the hell did that little... There was a little sister, right? There was a little sister. I'm pretty sure there was a little sister. So let's take the exploding buck in here. And well, there's a few more rooms we haven't been in yet. So let's go in here first. Into the casino. So let's whack our way through this place. Hello. There we go. And now I think I'm going to just complete the game with the wrench in hand. Because I heal every time I hit something. So we can hack this thing. So let's do that immediately. Research. No, we don't need to research. I just need to take that. Auto-hack the safe. And open it up. Ooh. Should check out the rooms first before I start inventing shit. So this is a casino. Another really nice area, which they did pretty well, actually. And this just has a lot of those slot machines again. But upstairs, we need to be careful, because I think upstairs there's a lot of those, yeah, electric wires. There we go. So we have more trap bolts and a crossbow. We haven't been using the crossbow yet, but I'm going to sooner rather than later. So let's take back telekinesis, take a corpse, and use that corpse to, well, free the area here. What the why the hell was the door open? Oh, it's the bolt. Never mind. Should I try my luck a few more times? That's stupid. Okay, never mind. That was immediately. Jackpot. Trophy, please. So now my wallet is filled to full. Lucky winner. There we go. Another trophy. We've been gathering trophies the last two episodes like crazy. I don't think there actually is anything else in this place. We just got the jackpot in triggering it once. That was actually crazy. So let's go back outside. Yeah, we never really been here. There's another batch of those splicers. Oh, holy motherfuck, that scared the bejesus out of me. So as I said, these guys are completely silent. Wow, holy motherfucking Christ. Fuck off. Fuck off, really. I mean, really. Jesus Christ. So I think these guys are the six that were in the fucking Christ. Fucking Christ. I hear stuff. I hear footsteps. I'm getting goosebumps all over again. So these guys are dead. They look dead. Okay, I'm getting completely paranoid here. I'm sorry for that. So there's the record store. Okay, so let's go inside of the record store. And this place seems to be lit aflame because there's a bit of smoke in the area. So let's take a look around. It looks like he set the records of Sander Cohen on fire. And there's someone in front of the fire, which we might assume is Kolb himself. Wait, why can I move? Okay, there we go. So Ryan's stable Tory, or stable boy,
Cohen's
sorry.
Not a musician. He's Ryan's stable boy. Ryan's corrupt policies crap all over the place, and Cohen flutters around clearing it up. But instead of using a shovel, like you would with a proper mule, Cohen tidies with a catchy melody and a clever turn of phrase. But no matter how nicely it sounds, he can't really do anything about the smell.
So Anna Culpepper is someone we haven't heard before, but Anna Culpepper is actually the rival of Sander Cohen. Someone he really, really dislikes, as we might encounter later on. So we drop down, and this guy looks dead and explodey. There we go. That just blew up. Kinda had a long timer to let us die for that. You do? With your kittens? So he just set the vents aflame, which actually causes the spider splices to go crazy. So they are set aflame though, so. And they actually have kitty masks, if you're wondering. Wow, that was actually big enough apparently. Okay, thank you Kolb for that. Okay, did we search? Oh yeah, our wallet is full, so we can't take any more money. So that was Kolb, really, really charming fellow. And there seems to be another one stuck there. Well, never mind. I can actually go down here into the vent to get back up. First aid kit. Oh yeah, we can use that. There's a charred corpse in here, and that's about it, I think. So now we can actually exit back out this way. So now we need to find Kolb again, because he disappeared. Yes, indeed we did. So yeah, that's not going to do much. Hello? There we go. Just took care of him with his own materials.
Nasty one. And my favorite. But I think I like him better this way. Take his damn photo. Chop, chop.
So Silas Kolb. The last picture down. And let's search him. Because he has quite a bit of interesting stuff. Wallet already full, of course. So we're gonna probably hack the thing downstairs. But let's see, I don't want to miss. So we've been in the casino. We've been. Oh no, so the surprise is something else in the casino. I am completely mistaken, I am sorry. So this is something else, so this is another casino. I think they're both casino, the other ones are mostly slot machines, but that's kind of what's in a casino as well. Just gonna quickly hack the vending machine down here. Yeah. Let's just buy it out, I mean I have that much money, and buy a few more Eve hypos we can in here, and buy the other hack tools as well. A few incendiary bolts. Oh, there we go. Another, don't we have any corpse here? Hi. She's standing on top of the... Goodbye. On top of the bolt, that was weird. So let's go back to the casino, we haven't been there, and I think that's pretty much the last thing we need to enter. What the? I keep hearing footsteps, so it's probably my own footsteps. So let's enter this place, and look at this. So there's another safe behind here, so let's auto-hack this one as well. I think there's, yeah, there she is. Goodbye. Let's open up the safe. More dollars and a first aid kit, so nothing really of use. I think there's a lot of money lying around in here, but I don't think there's much else of interest. What was that? Did the bolt just take out the light fixture? Apparently it did. Where's the other spider spikes? Oh! Camera! 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 Come back? You're a bitch! There we go. I said it to your face. Huh. Let's go to the other side. Whew! Hack it. There we go. Okay. Hello. Whoa! So that was the effect of the wrench lurker. She didn't know I was there, so I just karate chopped her in the face. That was actually pretty cool. Eve hypo, armor piercing rounds, we could use that. Transparent vodka, which is always transparent. Why the fuck am I saying that? And yeah, I don't think there's anything of use in this room aside from this audio diary, so... Bump Culpepper.
I just got the word to put the bump on Anna Culpepper. This isn't some gangster or hard-nosed political operative. We're talking about a dizzy twist what wrote a song or two that got on Orion's wig.
So, Anna Culpepper was, presumably killed by, this guy. By, on command of Andrew Ryan, because he didn't like what she was singing about. Do you have a little sister? Are there any little sisters? There is one more little sister in this area. But he isn't carrying any. Hi! I can see you! I can see you! Why? Jesus Christ! How many are there? So are you getting a little sister? Because I'd like a little sister. So you can see there's also a lot of stores that are just closed down, probably because of what happened here and the splices and all that. So he's going towards, and this is actually great, he is in front of both of my turrets. So that should actually make this pretty easy. I'm also going to do something else now that we have the opportunity. I can actually lay steel traps, trap bolts. So let's do this. And these are actually... Oh, shit. There we go. Oh, yeah, okay. For fuck's sake. I'm fucking this up really badly. So we have now two traps set. I'm gonna put the electric gel on. And probably just shoot a bit at him. No, not over there. No. So there we go. He went straight through the electric thingies, and now he's distracted by the turrets. And now electric gel in his ass, and that should actually just kill him. There we go. Thank you for the money, and rescue her. So that's the last little sister in this area, in Fort Frolic. So, shua. More Adam for us. I think this is going to be a bit of a longer episode since
Thank
I'll
you, mister.
Probably... Hello, did I actually take pictures of you?
Thank you.
I'm probably going to end it after we finish up Fort Frolic. There we go, fully researched the little sister. Another thing done. So let's head back to the main area, to the Fleet Hall, because I think we... Not the Fleet Hall, the atrium. Sorry. Because I think we did most of the things here, and I'm... scared shitless of all the spider spices in here. Those plaster dudes, I hate them. I'm actually scared again now that I reminded myself of them. So I think, yeah, we've been in the surprise, we've been in here, we've been in the Rapture Records, we've been in the Fortune Casino, the Pharaoh's Fortune, and we've been in both the upper and lower areas of Eve's Garden. Surprise, we've done that. We've done that as well. I hear them, but So we went down there as well. This is closed. So yeah. There he is, there he is. Where the fuck is he? There's another one. And I can fucking hear another one. I mean, come on. Get away. No. Okay, so we've been to every area there is in here. So I'm very glad I can leave. So let's put the final picture in. And hopefully get out of this place. And thank Sander Cohen. Because we're actually going to have our first little decision in the game to make. But I'll show you guys for yourself. So let's put the final picture in. There we go. Boop. And now look at that. So that's Sander Cohen himself in the flesh. So he took away his bunny mask, and now we can actually look at him in the flesh.
It's beautiful.
It's beautiful, he says. He really likes it, he says. And hopefully you're not gonna kill us, please.
Ryan is now here. Tell him Sander said hello. Oh yes, you may avail yourself upon one of my lesser works as a token of our time together. If you had become my one and true disciple, you might have been worthy of seeing inside the box of my most private news. But who knows if that man is yet even born. Now, go.
So he tells us that the way is open. We can go to Andrew Ryan now.
Remember? What happened to you?
Oh?
I've been trying to raise you for a dog's age. Never mind.
So let's take Medical Expert 2 and swap it out. So apparently we're getting attacked now. For some reason. So Sander Cohen is friendly. We can actually choose to kill him. But I'm gonna try not to. There we go. Because this is actually a decision you can make yourself. You can choose to kill him or not. So yeah, I don't know why I triggered the alarm. Not that it's needed anymore. But yeah, that was a bit weird. So he also told us that we are not yet his real muse, so we only got this one and not the other cabinet right here, which we can't unlock ourselves. And well, he just left. He just left. He's still here looking at the painting. We could kill him, but we're not going to just yet, because it's actually really cool what we can do with that. So now we can leave. This is the end of Fort Frolic, sadly, so this opens up again. And we can go on with our troubles and on to Hephaestus, the next area, the area where Andrew Ryan is said to be. But before we head there, of course, I'm going to take a little break. So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode and, of course, Fort Frolic, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I'd really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye.